Hey, how's it going, Spy here, and welcome to the post-apocalyptic wasteland. This is Cooking Simulator Shelter, where we're in the apocalypse, and I'm gonna be your chef today, where we're gonna make some awesome meals inside of this apocalyptic survival bunker. So, check it out! This is what we're working with. This is the kitchen! Isn't it beautiful? I mean, it's not much, but this is all we got currently. It is completely stocked up with food, considering that I am in the sandbox mode. We could go over here though. We could plant some stuff to grow more food. We're gonna get into that later. And we're also gonna head back upstairs to the wasteland because we gotta do a little bit of hunting to get some ingredients. So get some ammo and I think we're ready. Check that out right there. That looks like a good first ingredient, a radioactive rat. I think I got him. Sorry, dude. Thank you for your 2 rat meat. We're gonna use this for one of our recipes and it's gonna be tasty. You're gonna love it. So we're back in our kitchen here. I'm gonna pop up the recipes. This is all the stuff that currently uses rat. Look at this, grilled rat with potatoes. What? That sounds delicious. And on the left, we have our ingredients. I actually have to bake a potato. It might not be perfect, but we could do it. All right, we're gonna grab this pot. We're gonna bring it over here to grab all the stuff we need. It says we need chili flakes, smoke flavor. Oh my gosh, I don't know where everything is. Just give me a second. All right, here's our herbs, bam. And now we just gotta go grab some rat meat all the way over here. Rat meat, look at that. That looks juicy. And it only says we need 250 grams. This is 250 grams. Throw that right here. It says skewer the rat meat. Ooh, all right. Bam. Really? Just like that. I gotta season it. Got my ground cactus. How much do I do? 10 grams of ground cactus. Throw that down. It looks like we just need 10 grams of everything. So super duper easy. You can make this recipe at home if you really want it. I don't recommend using rat meat. And chili flakes, it looks like our rat skewer is ready to go on the grill for a good old 90 seconds. Set the timer, set the timer. That's 10 hours, 90 seconds, minute 20. Good enough. Yep. All right. And while that is cooking, look at it go. We're gonna have to get a baking tray with potatoes. Baking tray. Okay, well, let's go back here. Let's grab us some potatoes. Right there. So we're gonna need, I think it just asks for 2 potatoes, 300 grams, really? Okay, bake for 90 seconds. Over here at our oven, slide that bad boy in, close it, bam, 90 seconds. Okay, easy peasy. And look at this, our rat meat is looking so tasty. And our rat skewer is done. Be quiet, please, bam. Grab our rat skewer with our bare hands. Do I have to like take off product? There we go. That looks delicious. Actually, I'm just gonna move it over to this one and we're gonna put our potatoes with it. Let's take a look at our potatoes really quick. Okay, they need a couple more minutes in there. Or seconds, one of them.
4 to 6 days later.
And I think our potatoes are done. Oh, these are hot. Put them on the plate right there. Serve them with our skewered rat meat. And look at this. That looks so delicious. Well, I'm not gonna be eating it, but I'm gonna be sending it to you via the video. How's it taste? Whoa, 10 out of 10, really? I didn't think I was actually gonna master that, but don't forget to smack that like button if you really enjoyed that recipe, I did. Okay, so for my specialty dish, I'm not gonna be following a recipe. I'm gonna be following my brain. Before we do that though, I wanna plant some fresh stuff. So let's see if there's anything I really like in here. I do like mushrooms, but I've never had a blue mushroom before. So I'm gonna go and plant this bad boy right here. Okay, and we're gonna have to water it. Come on, there we go, it's watered. Now what do I do? Do I just turn it on? And there we go. It has 2 radiation, a 35% chance to grow a, what is that, a monster? What are these? Boosters, anti-monster, randomizer, speedy. Let's do a speedy thing here, just like this. Oh, okay. Whoa, fast growth. This might be bad. This might be bad. Oh, look at that. We got our blue mushrooms. So what my favorite dish is, it's usually sauteed and candied onions. So I'm going to be cooking that for you guys today. We got our pan here. That's what you need. We're going to need a pot so we can grab some mushrooms. I'm going to use the ones that we just grew. The blue mushrooms. Where are they at? Right here. So we're just going to grab a bunch and put them in the pot here like this. These ones are pretty big, so I don't think we need too many, considering that the pot will only hold three. All right, take this back. Oh, there's a big bowl here. Next up, we need onions, preferably sweet onions. Those look pretty sweet. I'll do two and maybe a little more mushrooms. You're gonna need a tiny bit of oil. So, no, not like that. Just in there. We need salt. We need salt. Cheese. Salty butter. That will do. All right, we got all our ingredients. That just flew out of my bowl. Next up, grab yourself a cutting board. Remember to follow these steps at home. You could do this with real mushrooms, real onions, salt, butter. Fantastic. But I would recommend doing it not as crazy as me. So we got the butter, right? We're just gonna toss this right in the pan like that. Same with our oil. We're not gonna turn it on yet though. Open the bottle, check this out. I'm a professional here. Just a little bit, not too much. And just chop everything up, like, bam, boom, bang. These are gonna be some fell on the floor. That's probably pretty good for the mushrooms. Onions, chop those things up too. And then transfer it all to your frying pan when it's heated. I should probably get it. I'm just gonna dump it all in right now.
You want to explain to me what you're doing here?
Look at that. Oh, that's perfect. Oh, that's gonna be so tasty. Make sure to grab a flipper. Look at these fine motor skills. Just like a human being in real life. Yep, this is what you do. While I'm waiting for that to cook, I think I'm gonna throw in some more plants here. I gotta go check that. Is it burning? It's gonna start burning. Turn it off. I'm gonna grow a bunch of things back here like this. There we go. Make sure to water them all. And while those grow, let's go check on our food. That's looking so tasty. Okay, let's transfer it to this plate here without the oil. Okay, let's get a different plate. Here we go. And look at that, sauteed mushrooms and caramelized onions. I'm gonna just put it here. It says shrimps in wine and tomato sauce. They got none of that right. This was sauteed onions with mushrooms. Well, at least I got 2 stars for that. Okay, now it's time to clean up the kitchen a bit with my handy dandy mop.
It's not doing anything. Wait a second.
What is happening back here?
This cactus is good. I took that.
Are these monsters?
Hello? It says don't
Jeez, they're trying to bite me.
Can I feed them? Hold on. Grab a piece of corn. Don't even know where I got this corn.
Eat this. Eat this piece of corn. Jerk.
Okay, that's it. I'm gonna have to go upstairs, grab the air rifle, and obliterate these little jerk.
Here we go. That's what you get. You're supposed to be plants, not monster plants that I can't use for cooking.
Probably can't use them. Come on, boom. One more. Bang. That's what you little jerks get. See, I don't know if we can really use them for anything. Let me grab a knife.
No, I can't really chop them.
I think he just goes in the garbage can, like this. Poor little dude.
Well, anyways, that was cooking in the apocalypse of spy cakes. If you enjoyed, don't forget to smack that like button and just stay sweet.
Oh, I missed it.
I got it. Everyone saw. I'm good at basketball. Oh, man.